Everybody, it's JoJo, and I'm here to do a top 10 favorite Christmas songs of all time. I'm going to go down the list from 10, my least favorite to my favorite out of 10, and then I'm going to give a little clip of each song as I go down the list. Okay, so I already said my lipstick, my perfume, and my eyeshadow, everything in the outfit of the day. I forgot to add my cream. I have Vanilla Bean Noel from Bath & Body Works on right now. I've been using that all month. So let's get started because, girl, I got a lot of shit. So, alright, so number 10 is, Christmas Wish by 98 Degrees. So, I like this song. This came out in the 90s. 98 Degrees was a boy band. I think it's a cute song. You know, we all love our Christmas songs. Like, when it comes to... Every year we love our Christmas movies, same as much as we love our Christmas songs. Like, Christmas songs play from, I think, middle of November all the way to after Christmas, you know, on the radio and whatnot. So, Christmas songs is a big part of the holiday season. So, Christmas Wish is a cute one. I'm gonna play a little tidbit right now. I'm trying to get to the chorus. It's cute. It's a boy band holiday song. It's cute. You know what I mean? If you feel it. So that's that. So I'm going to play like a little tidbit of each because I'm not going to play the whole damn song. Okay, so the next one is As Long As There's Christmas. So number 9 is As Long As There's Christmas. So this is, let me try to find the artist. This was in the movie Beauty and the Beast and Enchanted Christmas. This was a sequel to the Beauty and the Beast cartoon film. And it's sang by Roberta Flack. This is a really good song. Like, when I hear it, I kind of tear up a little bit because it's like, it makes me think of that movie. It makes me think of, like, that's literally one of my favorite sequels ever. It was in my favorite Christmas movies, too. Like, it's just a really good song. So let me play a little tidbit of this. This isn't that popular. Like, this doesn't play on the radio every holiday season. Like, this is not a popular one, but this is just something that's near and dear to my heart. You know what I mean? Like, it literally captivates you. I don't know who the guy's saying. It's a duet, but I don't know what the guy's name is. Isn't this nice? You know what I mean? You guys must have seen this sequel. And here's the chorus. It's so nice. It's a nice song. Anyways, that's what that is. Okay. So number 8 is another good song. Like, so this is also not a popular one. It's called Don't Save It All for Christmas Day by Clay Aiken, who was the runner-up on American Idol season 2. I like this song a lot. He has a holiday album himself, and he does his little thing on the holiday album. He has an amazing, beautiful voice, and this song was my favorite song out of that album. I don't remember when it came out, but here's the little sneak, little preview, a little tidbit of it. I try to get to the chorus part. I definitely have a theme. I like the nice, slow songs for Christmas. You know what I mean? This is the type of songs I like. It's nice. He has such a nice voice. Okay, anyways. So then number 7 is Winter Dreams by Kelly Clarkson. So her Christmas album is like one of the best Christmas albums that ever came out in life. Like, she has one of the best holiday albums. Winter Dreams, I think, is my favorite song out of the album, though. There's a few I like. I like Wrapped in Red. I like Under the Tree. But, like, I think Winter Dreams is my favorite one out of this album. Let me show you a tidbit. And she was the winner of, you know, American Idol. Yeah, nice song. You know what I mean? Nice song. So number six is, this one's actually popular. This one's more of a high beat Christmas song. So this is called Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays by NSYNC. So NSYNC, of course, had their own Christmas album, and I love this one. This is my favorite song. I have a few on my Christmas playlist, but like, this was my favorite one. Like, where is it? Here it is. Okay, so, you know, this came out late 90s. Like, you know what I mean? Like, Christmas songs, they bring you back in time, to a moment in time. You know, they bring you back to that Christmas. So here it is. Everything's okay. Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays. So good. Like, I think I even like this than more so than the regular albums. Like, I just love that song. Okay, number five. So we're going to the top five. I want you guys to guess what my top three is down below. Okay. I know there's so many Christmas songs. Okay, so number five is one that haunts me. Like, it literally like goes into my soul and like gives me goosebumps. So it's Believe by Josh Groban, and this was in the Polar Express film. So this song brings me back to my junior high. Like, it just brings me back, because I saw the movie on a school trip that year, and it brings back to that time. You know what I mean? Like, songs in general brings you back to moments in time, and this one just brings me back to that. I love the song. It haunts me. It literally gives me goosebumps every time. Even the big, like, that beginning, like, I can't. Even that, like, you know? Like, just feel the song. Like, feel this song right now. Like, this is crazy. Like, don't you feel it? Like, like I'm the radio station. Yeah, so there's like a little sneak preview of that song. So, I mean, everyone knows that song. That song's a really good one. You know, I mean, that movie was really, Polar Express is like really good, honestly. That was even in my, you know, that was in my favorite movies too for holiday season. Okay, so number four is, and this has been, I feel like everyone has a fucking, every artist has this song on their album. Like, everyone's done like a reboot of it, or it's their own version of it. But this is, my favorite version is of course the original. It's called Last Christmas by Wham. And I think George Michaels was the main artist, I think. So here's the, this came out, what, early 90s, late 80s? I don't remember. Yeah. This is a really good song. Everyone does a rendition of this song, like, every artist. But this is the best. Such a cute song. It's like a love song, but then it's not, because he's basically saying that he was in love with someone else last Christmas, and they didn't give him all that they could have, And so he fell in love with someone else this Christmas. So, yeah, it's a cute song. Anyways, so top three now, baby. So these three are like, you know what I mean? Like, it's the holiday season, bitch, for these songs. So number three is Where Are You Christmas by Faith Hill, which was the song that was in How the Grinch Stole Christmas, of course. So here it is. This song is like haunts me. Like, it's so, oh, so breathtaking. Her voice. Her voice has never sounded better than in this song. It's so good. Look at that. Like, don't you give me goosebumps, girl. I think this is the best song in a holiday film ever. It's been a hard year for me, for everybody, so. It's been a hard year for, everyone. You know what I mean? It's been a really hard year, so. These songs are just extra special this year. So, number two is I think it is the number one Christmas song of all time, honestly. Like, the number one. All I Want for Christmas Is You by Mariah Carey. That is like, this is the. I mean, I don't need to play it, but I'm gonna play it anyways. This one is like the classic. This must play a million times on the radio station every holiday season. So here it is. I don't know if you guys can see, like, you see the, it looks so cute on the album cover. From the fireplace. I can't sing right now. Be happy with a toy on Christmas Day. This is probably everyone's favorite, honestly. All I want for Christmas is you. Yeah, real good. Okay, so now number one. This was my personal favorite. I know, like, this isn't a popular one, and she didn't even come out with a Christmas album. This was just a one single she had. My Only Wish This Year by Britney Spears. Of course, it's a Britney Spears song. This is my favorite. Like, I don't know. There's something about this song and the lyrics that's just so cute, so fun, so festive. So, it's my favorite one, and I love Britney Spears, and this has been my go-to holiday song since birth, honestly, since I could listen to, like, since I could, like, comprehend music and, like, sing. So here it is. Someone to hold, baby. All I want is a big red bow. Isn't this cute? I have been so good this year. Tell me my true love is here. He's all I want just for me. Underneath my Christmas tree. Waiting here. Santa, that's my only wish this. So, you know what's going on with Britney Spears, right? Like, with her whole legal case with her father, who has all her assets and all her money, and she's going to court to try to get her money back, and he has hold of all her money because of her breakdown she had in 2007. So, he has control of all her money. Can you believe that? Like, she makes all this money, and her father controls everything. Like, she's way above 18 years old, so that should not be going on. Anyways, I think Macaulay Culkin had that same problem where, but it made more sense because, he was too young, Of course, he's not gonna be in control of his money at that age. Like, so his parents had it, but when he turned 18, the parents would not give the money to Macaulay Culkin still, and he wanted his money at that point because 18's you're an adult, and that's what it is. But, there was some kind of contract that when he turns a certain age, that's when he gets the money, but the parents didn't give him the money, so he had to go to court, so it was a whole thing. So, yeah, I mean, that's what, people, even parents, like, they get, like, they get money hungry. Anyways, so that was my top 10 favorite Christmas songs of all time. What are yours? Let me know down below. Let me at least know your top 3, girl. I really want to know what your favorites are, because everyone loves music, and Christmas songs are just special. Like, just, it's just a special genre, you know, it only comes once a year. So, I'm gonna go. I might film my mukbang now, and then I'm gonna leave, and then come home and film more things. Again, my Thanksgiving mukbang is not gonna be out until Thanksgiving Day, so I'm gonna upload all my other videos before Thanksgiving. The Thanksgiving mukbang is gonna be the last video I'm gonna upload from this day. I might even wear a different outfit. That's why, like, you see, I might even, because I want to wear something different, you know, because it's gonna be days later, so I want to wear the same outfit, and then, you know what I mean, so I'm probably gonna put on a different outfit for that video. So it doesn't look like I filmed it all on the same day, even though I'm literally telling you, like, up front, like, I filmed it all on the same day. So yeah, anyways, I love you guys, I hope you guys enjoyed, and see you guys in the next one, bye.